Welcome back, everyone. I hope you're doing well today. Today, we're going to get into one of the controversial topics in roster building when it comes to Diamond Dynasty, which is the created all-star player or the cap. Now, I thought this was going to be a short video because it's relatively simple, but since it is so simple, I'm going to put every single piece of information that I can give you about the created player. So this video will actually go into depth. If you're very new to the game or if you are trying to make decisions based on what type of created player you want to build, I should have all of that information for you in this video. We'll discuss the advantages of the created player, how you build your created player, what's the best created player to take, and also some of the best equipment to maximize his abilities. So let's get into it. And again, this is one of the more controversial topics because some people think it's cheesy and unrealistic. They don't really like the fact that it's not a real MLB player and you're kind of making something up and kind of giving yourself an advantage based on this player. But hey, everybody has a chance to use him. It's basically a level playing field. And if you don't, you're going to be at a disadvantage in some way. So let's get into why it's so important to have a created player. Because on the surface, it may seem like a created player is just a placeholder until you get some better cards, because they max out at 89 overall, which is kind of an average diamond. Well, it turns out that if you add equipment to your created player, they start getting boosted by about 10 or 20 points in a lot of the important categories. But those rating boosts can actually skyrocket your overall, and can make them pretty darn close to any 99 overall card at the game. We never actually see the overall change on the physical card, but when you get into the game, you will see the ratings boosted compared to what you see on the squad select screen. Now, the real advantage of the created player comes from this: the ability to switch hit and any swing that you want. Switch hitting obviously gives you some line of versatility, and the advantage for that is relatively straightforward. But choosing your swing can be the difference in about 50 points on your batting average. In case you weren't sure, different player swings in MLB The Show do have different timings and optimal contact points. In a lot of ways, an individual swing could be good or bad, depending on your own internal timing and personal preferences. Although there are some objectively good and bad swings in terms of like 90% of people agreeing one way or another. So keep an eye out for batting stances that you like or other people like, and try them out on your created player. Keep in mind a good or quote-unquote glitchy swing that you like doesn't always translate to a created player for some reason, so keep tweaking it until you find something that works. For instance, like, I liked Kyle Schwarber's swing, but for some reason on my created player it just didn't work properly. And that's another advantage about the cap: you can actually customize their appearance as many times as you want, including their swings and animations. The only time you can't do that is if you use a Sony partner for your created player. And if you want to know how to do that, you just use their name on your player and their face scan and player model will show up. So if you wanted to use Coogs, you go ahead and you type in Tim Coogler as your created player's name and everything will show up. But if you do this, you will not be able to change your player's appearance or name for the rest of the year. So choose wisely. But a final point on the advantages of cap: keep in mind whatever build you create will be usable for Diamond Dynasty online play. Whether it's a contact hitting shortstop or a power hitting right fielder, they're all good. You will be able to use them for a good amount of time throughout the year. However, when you compare some of these cards to other cards available in programs or on the market, you may find that they have very similar ratings, especially when looking at the outfield and corner infield positions. So while a maxed out center fielder might be a little bit better than Mike Trout, is he really going to be better than Willie Mays or Ken Griffey Jr.? Probably not. The cards that you do have a hard time coming by in the market are dynamic, well-rounded catchers and middle infielders. So after I explain how to level up your cap, we will also discuss which choices to make. So to get your cap started, go ahead into this menu within Diamond Dynasty and go and create your player. Get started with these menus, build your dude, all of which can be changed later if you don't like something. So you could start with Joe Random, just jump in here and press options if you're ready to go and build your player. Come back to him if you want to change the appearance later. And after that, you'll get a notification that new moments have been added where you can go and level up your card. But first, just go ahead and check the equipment screen and add whatever you have available. Unlockable animations are also cool, but they're not necessary for your cards, so you can take a look at those later. But now you can get into the created player programs on your right. Position players all have the same setup, and the pitcher is similar, but with a few tweaks. So we'll get into that in a second, but we'll just take a look at the catcher. Go ahead and get into this screen. And on your left is the missions, similar to the first inning program and things like that. And on the right is the card path to show how much the next card costs in program stars. There are three types of mission for the caps: grind, collect, and moments. Keep in mind there are 130 program tokens available for each position, and you only need 100 to max out that cap. So you can mix and match if you like. Last year, it seemed like it took about 100 hours to get it maxed out for one position, but this year it seems like you could do an entire position in just one weekend. In my opinion, the fastest and most effective way to get this done is to do the collect missions first, and then to do the moments. Moments have mixed reviews in general, and I can't say they're easy for most people, so give them all a few tries, and you'll end up finishing a few, hopefully. But the more you can do, the better, because you'll be able to get a higher level card, which you can then grind online with. The 78 silver is okay, but not great, and early in the year, even if you're using a gold created player online with half-decent equipment, is actually plenty and you won't really be losing anything offensively or defensively. With those cards, all you need to do is play 150 innings online, which will also finish the regular 100 innings, and that takes about 17 games. Now, if moments are too tough, or you don't want to spend the stubs on collection missions, which totally makes sense, you do get another 15 tokens for grinding the extra 300 inning mission, so it'll take some more time, but if you're willing to do it, it can save you some stubs. And by the way, if you are in the process of collecting teams for XP, which we'll talk about in a future video, make sure to drop by these missions right here so you can collect any of these cards before exchanging or quick selling them. You do get a few stubs back depending on the position, and of course, you get some program stars for your created player. Now that we've discussed how to level up your created player, let's talk about the decision making when it comes to them. You see at the end that there are two choice packs, each with 2 to 4 cards depending on the tier and position. To reiterate from before, pretty much all of the options are good, but some are actually better than anything else you can find in the game for a good portion of the year. And those are the created players that you want to focus on and build early. Keep in mind, unlike appearance, you are locked into a choice once you make it. You can choose 2 different builds for 2 different positions, since you can grind diamond caps at every position if you do like, you can only use 1 at 1 time, but you can grind all of them. But once you open your pack, you have to choose then and there. Keep in mind, you can press triangle on here and see the pack contents, so you can preview the cards before you ever open this pack, and I would definitely recommend doing that before you make your decision. So, what do you choose? As a general rule of thumb, you can basically find a comparable contact focus card at every position, for instance like an Ichiro or a Kenny Lofton or something like that. You can pretty much throw those out the window. Power always plays in Diamond Dynasty, so you won't really go wrong with a power focus because he also has a decent defense, and that will be the first pack at every position. When you do get into the final pack, however, you have 1 or 2 more options that might be more intriguing. First of all, at second base, there's no power focus, so go ahead and take the balance. You're going to be good with that. But at positions like catcher and shortstop, there is a premium placed on defense, especially on this year's game. So personally, I like the balance option at both spots because I think it gives you the most versatility and longevity for those players. Your power focus will give you an anchor for the middle of your lineup, basically for the entire year, especially if you're not someone who can or wants to spend the time getting the best cards throughout the year. If you're someone who expects to have an all 99 lineup in October, choosing a balance focus will at the minimum give you a plus defense with a plus bat at the bottom of the order when that time comes around, while being a top run producer and team MVP early in the year. For reference, most of my team is hitting in the low 300s at this point, an all diamond squad, while my balance focused second baseman with a Javi Baez batting stance is hitting 400 with major pop, batting third in my lineup. So that's as far as I'll narrow it down for you. It usually comes down between power and balanced, and I think you can make a decision from there based on what you're looking for in a competitive advantage. I will say this, if you're approaching your level 75 or level 100 XP rewards, you have a little bit different of a decision that you could make. Now, a lot of people want to take the 99 Kershaw or maybe the Diamond Ichiro when you get to the 75 reward, but there's also the Alan Trammell that's available at shortstop. I don't think he's probably that great. I don't think his defense is special enough to waste your 75 choice pack on that. And one of the only other really good shortstops available in the game right now at this moment is Fernando Tatis Jr., the Future Stars card, and he's about 60k at the time of making this video. Tatis will probably be a beast up until you get to Hall of Fame. Maybe his vision's a little low for that point, but he will be a very good card, but he's just a little bit expensive. Now, when you get to level 100, there is the 99 Joe Morgan with pretty solid defense, great speed, and very solid hitting, and actually at this point in the year, can probably be a run producer for you. Now, will Joe Morgan be an endgame card? Maybe, maybe not, probably not. But at this point in the year, if you were to take Joe Morgan at level 100, you probably have your second base set for probably a couple months. That leaves you with a catcher and shortstop. So again, you have Alan Trammell and Fernando Tatis. I think Tatis is a much better option than Trammell, but Trammell seems like he is usable. And you have Joe Torre, Behind the Dish, maybe Mike Piazza if you want to do the Mets collection, and maybe the Johnny Bench at the level 75 reward. So after you look at all these players early in the year, let's say you do take Joe Morgan, then you're set at second base. All you have left is shortstop and catcher. Now personally, I think the best move right now is to put Joe Torre behind the plate, although some people have a hard time hitting with him, and putting your created player at shortstop. It's just very hard to get an affordable, dynamic shortstop at this point in the year, and at least if you have Torre, he only costs about 30 to 40k. All the other positions on the diamond you can kind of pick and choose. There are good options around the diamond, but those three positions, if you have those three decisions made, you grab Joe Morgan at level 100, you put Torre behind the dish, and you put your creative player at shortstop, you might have one of the most balanced lineups in the game. So there are a few decisions to be made beforehand, of course. Do you have the stubs for Torre? Are you close enough to the Joe Morgan? If you are, then that might be a decision path for you. But otherwise, those three options, you can't really go wrong. Now there's two more points I want to talk about before we end this video. First is, we've seen that bullpen arms are kind of scarce when it comes to 99 overall cards. So closer cap is not a bad option at all. Doing the pitcher missions actually unlocks a starter and a closer for you at the same time, so that saves you some grinding. When you get into the choice packs, you end up choosing two cards, again one reliever and one starter. I think that your choice here should be based on an evaluation of who you pitch well with and base your choice off of that. Keep in mind you don't get to choose your pitches, they are predetermined and listed at the top right for each card, and closers only have 3 pitches and starters only have 4. I think the balance focus again looks pretty sweet, especially with 98 in the back pocket, but it also has solid pitch selection and decent speed differentials. So if you wanted to go balance focus for your closer, that would be my recommendation, but again, you can't really go wrong. Just take a peek at your ERAs with your current pitchers and see if there's a resemblance to one of those cards and just try to base your card off of that. And finally, the last thing I want to talk about in this video is equipment. So when you go to the community market, you see a lot of high-priced goods with diamond ratings. And to start off, you want to shoot for gold equipment. Now you will lose a point or two in all of your ratings compared to diamond equipment, but it's going to be for a fraction of the price, so it is worth it, especially early in the year. To decide on what you want to buy, you can choose to go all in on certain ratings, compensate for a flaw, or keep your guy balanced with whatever you choose. For instance, if you took power focus, you could get a bat with high contact and low power to balance you out, or you could get a bat with high power and low contact to keep maxing out your power. If you're not sure what to get, power always plays, so focus on power ratings and just adjust from there. Keep an eye out for cards with high stats in durability, discipline, and pitcher ratings. These are the only ones that are inefficient and kind of useless in a lot of ways, so they should be minimized or avoided so you can get the most out of the other ratings that are available. So if you load up on gold equipment, you can basically do it for about 5 or 10k stubs. And basically, for about 5 or 10k stubs, you're turning an 89 overall average diamond into an absolute superstar, potentially endgame player in your lineup. So I think that's all the info I can give you about the created player. If you're new to MLB The Show, hopefully that gives you a good understanding of what happens with the created player and how good he can really be. And if you've been playing for a while and just want to know kind of the information on how to make your decisions, hopefully this video helped you out with that as well. I will be dropping a lot more videos on gameplay tips and other tips throughout Diamond Dynasty, so keep an eye out for that, and we will also start out some Road of the Show and maybe some March to October series eventually as the year goes on. At the moment, we don't really have a set schedule for videos. I want to just try to get as many of these videos out as possible at the beginning of the year so you guys can get going and maximize your time. If you do have some more questions, leave them in the comments or stop by the streams on Twitch. Thank you guys for watching. I hope this video helped, and I will see you guys later.